are some pretty insane stories out there in the world of mythology. Each culture has their own cool and sometimes bizarre stories of their gods, and they're all pretty fascinating. Today we're gonna take a trip back in time to ancient Egypt and discuss some of their deities' strangest tales as we count down the top 10 weirdest things that Egyptian gods did. At number 10, brotherly love. There were some weird things happening between the gods in Egyptian mythology, as we will come to learn through this video. To get us started on this journey through the strangest of stories, let's talk about some serious closeness between the gods Osiris and Isis. These two gods were husband and wife, but they were also brother and sister. Yeah, it's weird, but they were gods, so I guess it was fine. These two ruled Egypt until their other brother Set killed Osiris. When her husband died, Isis went on a search to find Osiris's body because she just really wanted to have a child with him and just wasn't gonna let pesky old death get in her way. When she found Osiris's remains, she was able to resurrect him for long enough for them to conceive a child. However, that process was a little difficult because she wasn't able to get the most important part of him for that because a fish had apparently eaten his member. Again, Isis was a very resilient woman, and quite crafty too, because she just crafted him a new device, if you will, and they went on to produce a son, Horus, who would later become the new king of Egypt. This story is a little weird, don't get me wrong, but it's also a story of perseverance, I guess, so maybe it's not all bad. At number 9, trophies. I know a lot of people like to save little mementos and souvenirs from things that meant a lot to them in life. People save movie stubs from their first date with someone, little objects from their childhoods, and a whole collection of other things saved from different points of their lives. There was an Egyptian god who sort of did the same thing, but a little creepier. Well, actually, it was a lot creepier. The god Anubis was the god of mummification, and I guess you could say that he just really liked his job. He was part of the embalming process for some big names like Osiris. See, tying it back to the previous story, when the god Set killed his brother Osiris, he got pretty buddy-buddy with Anubis because he offered Osiris's organs to the god of mummification. But not for Anubis, since he was known to collect pieces of the remains of people that he had embalmed. He had a thing for limbs and other remains, I guess. It was a weird collection to have, that's for sure, but for the god of mummification, it almost seems fitting. Before we carry on talking about some of these strange things that Egyptian gods did in their mythology, why not leave a like on this video if you're enjoying it so far, and while you're at it, maybe consider subscribing to the channel to see more videos like this one. At number 8, the last snack. For the Egyptians, a person's burial and their soul's final journey was a very big deal. We are probably all familiar with the mummification practices of the ancient Egyptians and all that, but what comes after was also pretty interesting. When someone died, it was believed that their soul would then move on to be judged. The soul would leave their body and go to the underworld, searching for the Hall of Truth. Once they found it, they would then be judged on who they were in their life, and if they passed the test, then they got to go to paradise. But if they failed, then they became a nice little snack for the goddess Amit. Amit was known as a demon goddess and dubbed the Devourer of Amenti. When the deceased was tested and their heart was weighed against a feather, if they failed that test, then Amit would eat the person's essence and they would vanish for eternity. Obviously, you wouldn't want that to happen, so I guess this was just an incentive for Egyptians to live life as a good person. At number 7, down the Nile. Now I know that I've mentioned the story of Set and Osiris a couple times now, but their story is just so messed up and weird that I have to keep including the best parts of it. Anyways, we all know that Set overthrew his brother Osiris as a king of Egypt, and did so by killing him, but let's talk about exactly how that happened. Set was a really jealous guy, and he resented his brother for being king, so he devised a plan to trick his brother into a coffin. Set had a coffin designed exactly for Osiris's measurements, and while at a party, Set challenged Osiris to get in it, as he promised that he would give the coffin as a gift to anyone who could fit inside it. So yeah, it was rigged from the start. So Osiris gets inside, and obviously it was a perfect fit. What he didn't know though was that this was where he would remain forever because Set sealed his brother in the coffin and sent it down the Nile River. After that, Osiris' wife slash sister Isis went to go find him and blah blah blah, we already know what happens next. At number 6, Lady of Plagues. Guys, if you haven't already clued in, we're still in a panorama, a panzerati. A pandemic. It seems like it'll never end, and after learning about the Egyptian goddess Sekhmet, I think I know why we're all going through this. It's because someone pissed her off big time. Sekhmet was known as the Lady of Terror, and if you don't get a good sense as to who she was just by her name, Just you wait. This goddess had the ability to spread pestilence and plague against anyone who remotely angered her. So judging by that, I think if you believe in this kind of thing, someone has some serious apologizing to do. Because of this insane power, Egyptians were brought up to know that they had to stay on Sekhmet's good side, otherwise it would be risking the health and safety of themselves and those around them. So this is a PSA to whoever made Sekhmet so mad. Please go apologize. Buy her some flowers. Make a sacrifice or two if you have to. Please just make her stop. It's literally my birthday today and all I want to do is live out my 20s in peace. Please, just do it for me. At number 5, kitty love. We all know that the Egyptians loved cats. Why? I don't know. I honestly can't see why you would worship those angry little fur devils, but hey, to each their own, I guess. The Egyptians even had their own goddess for cats called Bastet, and though you might think that she was just some crazy cat lady goddess, you would be very, very wrong. Bastet had a dark side to her and was known as the Lady of Dread or the Lady of Slaughter. Kind of fitting for a name for a cat goddess, since they are also evil to their core. She was known to kill other gods, like the god Apophis, whom she slaughtered by cutting off his head. Regardless of her dark past though, the Egyptians still worshipped her, and many even worshipped her by bringing her offerings of mummified cats to her temple. Cats bring out the darkness in people, I'm telling you. At number 4, Boozy Blood. Sometimes we make bad decisions when we're emotional. Like those times that people punch walls when they're really mad and totally regret it afterwards. Well, even though they were deities, sometimes the Egyptian gods would do some regrettable things too. Ra, the sun god, had a mighty temper and was known to make some pretty rash decisions. At one point, Ra decided that he wanted everyone to just die, and so he instructed his daughter Hathor to slaughter all the humans that she could find. Hathor was totally on the same page and was like, okay, bet, and went off to kill some humans. Luckily for humanity though, Ra came to his senses and had a change of heart, but by the time he caught up to Hathor, she became so bloodthirsty that there was no stopping her. So in an attempt to trick her into stopping her killing conquest, Ra filled 7,000 jars with beer and gave it to Hathor, who then became so drunk that she just gave up on her mission and decided not to kill everyone. Now they say that alcohol can't solve all your problems, but in this case it certainly did. At number 3, creation. There are so many creation stories out there created by various religions and civilizations. One of the more bizarre creation stories, however, belongs to the ancient Egyptians because their first god did something a little weird to create life as we know it. These ancient people believed that their very first god, Atum, created himself, and as such, he had no wife and literally no one else to potentially procreate with. And so to create his children and thus create humanity, he pumped the hose and released humanity, if you get what I'm saying here. If not, you're too young to be here. Anyways, out of his pleasurable process, he created his kids Shu and Tefnut. This legend also created the term the god's hand and was used to refer to women back in ancient Egypt, since Atum's hand played the quote unquote female role in the creation of his offspring. But yeah, I guess you could say that Atum was very pleased with what he created. At number 2, giant snake. There were a lot of strange animals in Egyptian mythology, one of them being a giant snake. The Egyptian god Apep was a giant snake who had some serious snake beef with their sun god Ra. They were polar opposites, Ra being the light, literally, and Apep representing darkness, chaos, and evil. One day, Apep just seemed to have had enough with Ra and all of his sunshine, goodness, and positive vibes, and just swallowed him up. He gobbled up Ra and the sun, leaving the world in complete darkness. Luckily, the other gods were there to save the day, and they had to slice Apep's belly open to free Ra and restore light to the world. This evil danger noodle lost this battle, but at least he got a taste of that spicy meatball in the sky. And finally, at number 1, a hearty meal. There are two sides to every person. Some people are nice on the surface, but they have a dark core that they keep hidden from the world. And the same could sort of be said for the Egyptian god Khonsu. You see, the gods were seen as helpful, but people also feared them, for good reason. I mean, these guys could pack a punch, and Khonsu was one of those guys with a serious dark side. Khonsu was the god of the moon, and was also seen as the god of healing. Sounds super positive and all, however, he was also known to eat people's hearts. Yeah, human hearts were a choice snack of his, but he was also known to dine on the hearts of select gods as well. He definitely isn't the guy to mess with because you might become his next hearty meal. Before we wrap things up for today, I want you guys to leave a comment down below telling me what you thought the most insane story from this video was. The Egyptian gods did some weird stuff, so tell me what shocked you the most down in the comments. Anyways, that's it for me. I've been your host, Bree Room, and until next time, stay safe, make good choices, and stay sweet, bumblebees. After that, Osiris' wife/sister went, oh my god, come on, brain.